unction that this anointing, capital B business, and the anointing that you have been gifted from anointing that somebody else has. Hallelujah. So the difference between the two ministrations was unction. So when the musician performs lyrics, words, it can inspire the mind, but the music makes it have an effect on the spirit. It makes it have an effect on the spirit. And what music does, or what something that has function does, either positive function or negative function, is that it draws your spirit to somewhere. You know, those of us that are scientists or engineers, we know about positive poles and negative poles in electricity. There is the positive pole and there is the negative pole. And when you mix certain chemicals and certain things, certain ions, they are some are attracted to the negative, some are attracted to the positive. What music or what such unction does, either positive or negative, is that it attracts your spirit towards a particular side of spirit. So if it's a positive spirit or a positive unction, it attracts you towards, it attracts your spirit manner. You may not even know what's going on, because it's something that happens slowly over time. It will not attract your spirit towards the spirit of God. It will draw your spirit. So the more it draws your spirit towards the spirit of God, it dulls. It dulls your spirit towards your life negative spirit. It dulls. It takes a long time. It takes a long time. It can take a long time. It can be on a long process many times of hearing and hearing and hearing. It is drawing you to a particular time. And if it's a negative function, it will be drawing your spirit, whether you are a believer or not. It will be drawing your spirit towards the negative side and be dulling your spirit towards the side of the spirit of God. It can take a while, but it happens. Slowly but surely. It is like the effect of running water on stone. Hallelujah. Can water break stone? Answer me, can water break stone? Those of you that are not magicians can answer me, can water break stone? Submit to you that music the arrangement of the sound. You may take the word and it's dead for your mind and educate your mind. But that's not all. That's not all you have received. You have received a lot of other things in addition. A lot of Jara has entered. And it takes time. It takes time. That's why it's advised that you should select it. Now, I will not come here and say, never listen to any secular music. Because actually, there is not everything that is like that. There are some that can be harmless, but you don't know them. You cannot know them. That's why it's very simple. Because you don't know there's some problem with the Christian. No. As a Christian, be circumspect. Be careful. Because what you hear, I'm not talking about words like this. What you hear, including those good words, what you hear goes beyond your mind. Who also gains the spirit. So I want to say here that to my teenagers and to the rest of us, though some secular musicians may produce songs with good inspirational words, the root of the matter of this my discussion is not about the words. The root of the matter is in the music. This is not to say that every secular music is carrying negative function. But I can say categorically that no secular music can carry positive function. No secular music. No matter how no secular music can ever carry a positive function. No secular music can ever carry a positive anointing. It's not possible. It's either it's carrying a negative anointing or it's not carrying anything. So, let me tell you, my children, that any music that is not for God is not for God's children. Any music that is not made for God, that is not done for the purpose of honoring or glorifying God, that is not made, that is not sent to God or for God, is not for God's children. So it's definitely the term. We are you standing on what part of your father? Or are you standing on the part of your father in this matter or not? This is very important for you to know. Because God says, in that scripture that we discussed, God says, you are carrying my unction. The little children, you are carrying what? Unction. Unction. So let's be serious. This is where I want to draw conclusion for you. Quickly read the scripture. That John